Hey guys, it's Erica, and thank you so much for watching this video today. So it is October 1st, and I actually had the time this evening that I thought I would go ahead and film a favorites video for you. Do you see the Piper hair flying in the air? Here she is. Honey, she's here. Okay, look at her tears where she's crying all day. Y'all like her new collar? How gorgeous. It's mommy's baby. All right, so I have a lot of things to talk about today, and we really don't need to waste any time because this video is going to be for heck and ever long. So the first thing that I wanted to talk to you about, my first favorite, is actually an activity that me and my mom and my aunts did last night, and I don't have it here because I already took it to work. I wasn't really aware that I would film this soon, you know, like just from last night, a favorites video. Otherwise, I would have kept it here, but I went to Hobby Lobby and found these little miniature canvases that you paint. And I think I got a pack of six for $3.99, I think. And then they had a little four pack of easels, and you could either get like natural wood or black. And I got black since it's like fall. And we hand painted our own little canvases here at home. So me and my aunt both did a fall theme one. I did a pumpkin with my first name initial. She did a pumpkin with her first name initial. And then my mom did the Grinch, like holding the little ornament. And my other aunt did a gingerbread man. So it's just a really fun way to spend an evening with, you know, your friends or your family, your loved ones, and it gives you this little memento that you'll always have. And whenever I do like a painting class with my friends, or like the one I did with my mom and my aunts last night, I always write the date and who I was with on the back of that, just so I can always look back and remember who was with me. So I call them my ladies. They're my backbone in this life. And forevermore, when I see that little canvas, I'll always think of a perfect day on earth that I shared with them. So highly recommend that. Even if you're not artistic, I'm not really artistic. It's just really fun, and they turn out better than you think. They really do. I just Googled like canvas ideas, like painting ideas, and took screenshots with my phone, and that's what we used for the inspiration. So I just wanted to mention that really quick. Other stuff that I've got some household, some beauty, a little bit of fashion, a little bit of jewelry. Let's go ahead and start with the makeup favorites this month, because I've had some things that I've truly, truly loved. And I'm a creature of habit when it comes to makeup. So I don't always look for the newest and the, you know, whatever just hit the market. Once I find something that I love, I really tend to stick with it. So I get excited whenever I buy anything new, right? Number one, hands down, beauty favorite of the month, my girl Emily. She came out with her own palettes. You have no idea how happy this makes me. Emily is my friend, and I love her. And do you hear that, Emily? That's your own private little UK cheerleader over here rooting you on. She knows what's up. She knows the UK cheerleaders be the best in the what country? Mm-hmm. So guys, in case you hadn't seen it, my friend Emily is Emily Noel 83 here on YouTube. She did have a collaboration with Makeup Revolution. These palettes are gorgeous, okay? This is huge. So crazy affordable. I'll put the price down here. I love the packaging of these palettes. Like, it's substantial. Like, I know it looks pretty. Like, it's pretty and shiny and has this big mirror. This mirror is no joke. There you all are. But I love the packaging. Like, it's one of my favorites that I own. I love palettes like this that give me a lot of versatility, a lot of different looks. I can say at this point, I've used every shade in this palette, like truly. And that's saying a lot because there's a lot to use, right? My favorite shade in the palette, believe it or not, hands down, the cream, okay? I'm crazy particular about a brow bone highlight. I like them to be matte. I don't like any kind of glitter or anything like that. So that one is perfect. There's very few brow bone highlights that I rave about. This is one of them. Also in the Marc Jacobs, the Lolita, I love that color. And then Too Faced has a couple of shades, like in their chocolate bar palette, that work like this as well. So love that pretty brightening brow bone highlight. I always use these two for my crease shade, for blending out my crease. And then I'm automatically drawn to any kind of greens in a palette. So those are probably also a favorite. And then Cheer and Love Tones. I have burned those up in my crease to like deepen up the crease because my favorite colors of fall are wine and mustard. That's what I'm wearing today. See my mustard colored dress, the wine colored earrings. Honey, it don't stop there. No, it don't. These tights. I know. You're impressed, right? Hoisting my leg up there. Honey, I love them. Got them on Amazon. But anyways, I love mustard and wine. So I've been blowing out my crease with Cheer and Love Tone. And then for a lid shade, I love Pizzazz with Eve Rose popped right on top, honey. Absolutely gorgeous, Emily. You did such a good job. I'm going to link her video down below where she talks about the palette because she like named each shade and it's like adorable and sweet and genuine just like she is. And then her other palette is called the Needs Palette. And this is, she described this. She has several different Makeup Revolution palettes that she loved different colors from each one of the palettes. And she put them all in one for us. Yes. So you have like your bronzer, your blush, your highlight. This shade right here, you can set with your under eye. I mean, it's so good. This is a great work highlight. I mean, I'll work whatever. Let's get real. But this is a real good work appropriate if you're like working an office setting like I do. Really, really nice. And then some beautiful eyeshadows there as well. So you knocked it out of the ballpark. Guys, you can get that on Ulta's website and the Makeup Revolution site. Although they have been staying sold out, which is a great thing, right? But I'm just so proud of her. Emily, all of the good things that have came your way and are going to continue to come your way, you're so deserving. So I'm just so happy for her. And it truly is really, really good product. So highly recommend those. That is the only eyeshadows that I've worn this month, truly, 100%. The only other shadow that I have worn, like I said, I'm obsessed with mustard and wine. So paired with those wine colors, I just use like a yellowish eyeshadow. This is the Jaclyn Hill palette with Morphe. And this is the shade in Creamsicle. Any kind of yellow matte eyeshadow would work, whatever you've got in your palettes. Chickadee by Makeup Geek, that's one that pops in my head. Any kind of shade like that. So works so good. I just blow it out on my crease and then deepen it up with the kind of maroon shades. So my girl Angie at work, we are tight, she and I. I'll put some pictures of us here. We've lately been recreating some really funny photographs at work and like they're hilarious. So if you have any funny photos you would like to see us recreate, honey, just send them to me, okay? Send them to me on Facebook or Instagram or wherever. And honey, we'll be recreating them. So anyway, she wears this like beautiful highlight, right? And for so long, like she'll wear this one shade. And I'm like, what is your highlight today? Every single time she told me it was Anastasia Unicorn from the Dream Glow Kit. And she was like, it's straight up glitter. And like, that kind of turns me off. I won't lie because I don't really wear a glitter highlight. I like more of, say, a glowy highlight, right? Glitter be emphasizing like textural issues and stuff on there too, okay? You know, you girls stepped up her skincare game quite the bit. So and honestly, I just don't even care about texture these days anyways, okay? It just is what it is. So I just went ahead and ordered the Dream Glow Kit, okay? These are straight up glitter, okay? They are beautiful though. And what I will say is, it's not just like colored glitter with no color in the background, okay? These have that kind of metallic-y highlight in the background covered with a little sprinkling of glitter. Does that make sense? This is the shade Unicorn. This is the whole reason I bought this palette. What? Okay. Are you going to focus? There you go. Do you see that? Okay. Do you see how the light catches that? I'm not even lying. I mean, I'm wearing it today. I don't know if you can see it. Maybe we should zoom in. Hit far. Let's see. Now let's let it focus, okay? Yes. Do you see that? Magical moment right there on my cheek. Okay, let's go a little closer. Yes, perfect. Guys, I love it. I mean, I've not been this stoked about a highlight in a coon's age, right? I love Anastasia Unicorn. also on my cheek, okay? My favorite blush for fall of life. I don't think it's ever going to change. Narcissin. Okay, I've mentioned this so many times. It's the perfect plummy colored blush for fall. Is it going to focus? There you go. Okay. Should I do a little swatchy swatch? You paired this with the Anastasia Unicorn. You've got some magnificent looking cheeks, baby girl. I'm not lying to you. It's what I'm wearing today. I mean, it's what I wear like every day if I can. So, highly recommend the both of those. They are superb. I just posted on Instagram last night. I was asking you all if you had any recommendations for a staining liquid lipstick. Am I too zoomed in? There we go. Okay. For a staining liquid lipstick, because my lips are shiny and they repel liquid lipsticks. Okay. That's just how I'm made. So if a liquid lipstick doesn't stain my lip, I have that telltale sign of it wearing off in the center of my lip. I can't stand it. So a lipstick that stains my lip, a liquid lipstick that stains my lip, is my best option because as it wears off, my lip is that color and it doesn't show. And y'all did leave me several ones to try. So I am going to pick those up and try them. I did pick up several new liquid lipsticks this month. I mean, I'm talking like numerous, okay? Two that I want to mention that actually did work for me. The first one is Dose of Colors in the shade Desert Suede. This is that really pretty kind of grayish color that a lot of people wear. Like a purpley brownish gray. Does that make sense? Like, I love this color. This does not stain. That being said, it stays on so well, it kind of gets a pass for me. Like, it really does work. The other shade is this really special shade by Jeffree Star. It's called No Tea, No Shade. It is not your typical just matte liquid lipstick. It is metallic. It has a sheen to it. It is unlike any other liquid lipstick or any lipstick that I own. I mean, it truly is just a really different color. And I know there's a lot of drama that surrounds like certain YouTubers and stuff. Listen, you girl, don't get involved in that. In my private life or virtually, so none of that. I'm talking about makeup. And let me tell you, while this one doesn't stain as well, it stays on so well that it also gets a pass for me too. Like, it's so pretty. And the days that I wore both of those, people were like, what's on your lips? Is that all my beauty favorites? I wrote them down, honey. We gotta be looking it up. The only other thing is like my nail polish. So I've worn the same nail polish for 6 weeks. Like, I mean, I take it off every weekend, but then I just polish them again. The only thing I've got on my nails is the OPI nail polish in Black Onyx, if you can see that. And this is one coat, if you can see like how my nails look. And it stays on so good. It's opaque. Like, I love this nail polish. And then as far as scents go, I've mentioned this perfume so many times. I bought this same bottle, this one bottle, it's all I've ever had of it, in Las Vegas maybe 3 years ago, 4 years ago, I don't even know, from Anthropologie, okay? This is called Vanille. This is not just a vanilla perfume. This has like a caramely vanilla scent. If you can see, I'm really low. I need to get another bottle. This was $18 from Anthropologie. It is delicious. It is so good. And like, I got car sick one time in grade school riding in my friend's mom's car over like the mountain where we lived. And she had on Vanilla Fields perfume. Like, I can't even stand to smell anything like that now, right? This is not like that. This is like yummy. Like a caramely vanilla. Guys, get this perfume, okay? Outreamer Paris, I think, is the brand of it. And it is in vanilla. Let's go ahead and talk about hair care. You're going to see a general theme here. I have been blessed with so many wonderful people in my life. People that take care of me. Help me get things that I need, okay? And while she does choose to remain nameless, honey, I've got a little angel in my corner that helps me get my Olaplex. So this is Olaplex 1. Olaplex 2. She got me, you basically use 2 to 1 what you do. Like, you need basically double Olaplex 2 of what you do of Olaplex 1. So she got me 2 bottles of this. The Olaplex 1, she got me big liters of shampoo and conditioner. And I did pay her for them. And these are very expensive, okay? But this will last so long. I have been doing an Olaplex 1 and 2 standalone treatment in my hair twice a month. It says on their website you can do a standalone treatment once or twice a month just to improve like the health of your hair. And I just like my hair to stay like pretty and shiny and healthy. So I love Olaplex, and these are definitely, definitely huge, huge parts of my hair care routine. And then also this month, I've been using the Olaplex 4 and 5. This is the shampoo and the conditioner. You get these from Sephora. The bottles are only 8.5 fluid ounces, and they run about, what, $26, $28 a piece, I think, something like that. That being said, even though it's a small bottle, especially the shampoo, even though it is sulfate free, it has a really good lather, so you really don't have to use very much of it at all. And then I try to just use the conditioner sparingly as well. But even though they're not that big of a bottle, I truly love that shampoo and conditioner. I think it's really, really good stuff. So, I mean, really with Olaplex, I think it speaks for itself. It's good stuff. Guys, have y'all seen this? Okay, it's called Color Wow. And it's the Dream Coat Supernatural Spray. Okay. You can get this on Amazon, eBay, wherever. And this is only like maybe $25, $28, something like that. So what this is, you wash your hair, towel dry it, and then on your towel dried hair, you just take it like section by section and spray it. Coat your hair really well, and then take a comb and kind of like, or wet brush, whatever you use, honey, and just brush it through, okay, so that you evenly distribute this product. This is like a polymer that coats your hair, okay? This lasts like 2 to 3 shampoos. You don't have to use this every time you wash your hair, honey. It stays on there. And it is activated by the heat from your blow dryer. So you have to blow dry your hair in order for this to work. But like, honey, you spray this on, you comb it through your hair, you know, brush it out, and then use your blow dryer. You can either round brush it or just blow dry it, whatever. It makes your hair so silky and shiny. Like, I mean, it'd be shining to the gods. Let me tell you what, you're going to love this. I mean, if you really struggle, if your hair is damaged, if it's dull, if it's fried, okay, whatever, try this. I think you're going to be really amazed at just how good this works and just how shiny and soft your hair is going to look. Like, I think you're going to love it. So, highly recommend that. And again, honey, I got mine on Amazon. That's where I get, like, what, everything? Moving right along, let's talk about some jewelry favorites. So, this is the watch that I always wear. It is a Citizen Eco Drive. It is, let's just pop it off. I can't even show you like that. When I say Eco Drive, that means it is powered by the sun. So you do not have to, I don't have the date set on this. It says the 31st. I need to roll it on around to the next day. But it's powered by the sun. So you never have to change the battery in this. That is the biggest thing for me. I don't want to change a watch battery. It's two-tone. It's waterproof. You can swim in this. You can dive up to, I think, maybe 30 feet in this. It's everything that I need. It's pretty, it's plain, it's simple, it's dressy, and you don't have to change a watch battery. That is huge for me. That and being two-tone, because I wear a lot of white gold and yellow gold. I bought this little bracelet from Kate Spade. Do you see it? It is two-tone, if you can see that. And it perfectly matches my watch. So I pair them together, but they do match each other perfectly, and I wear them all the time on my wrist, because it will go, again, like I said, with white gold, yellow gold, whatever. And then this ring, I found this on QVC, and it comes in several different colors. This is silver and yellow Madagascar sapphires. So you can get the standard like blue sapphire. They have a pink sapphire, and then, of course, the yellow. The yellow makes it look two-tone. I love the multi-layers of the ring, and I'm crazy about it. So it goes perfectly with all of that jewelry. It just matches really, really well. Could not be happier with those pieces. And then as far as, what should we do next? fashion. I love these jeans by Universal Thread. You get this at Target. I do love this like mustard color. Honey, I bought every color that got. I've got red, burgundy, black, mustard. I love them. And guys, so comfortable, so affordable, $27. Honey, all the fashion pieces that I mentioned are from Target. Love me some Target, honey. So here is this shirt. I have already worn this to work on our casual Friday, dress down Friday. It's by the brand Grayson Threads. I don't know. I've never heard of that brand. But it is in the juniors department. And it says black eyeliner, hocus pocus, pumpkin spice, full moon, and sugar high. Love this. And what I love about it, it is like a sweatshirt, but the inside is not fleecy. So it's not like crazy hot. It just feels like almost like t-shirty material, you know? So love that. It's adorable. Anything hocus pocus is obviously in style, right? And then this jacket. I've not had to wear it yet, okay? But I wanted to mention it in my favorites video in case y'all wanted it, honey. You know, it's probably going to sell out. It is by the brand A New Day, okay? Is A New Day the new exhilaration at Target? I think it is. But it's got this beautiful rose gold, like, hardware on it. You can cinch the waist in. This is like a standard kind of barn jacket. What's this called? Anorak? I don't even know, honey. In the back, it's got this adorable little kick pleat. Where are you at, kick pleat? There it is. Like, see how cute with the rose gold metal. Guys, it's beautiful. Again, wine colored. Perfect for fall. Like, come on. I love it. And like, that's the perfect kind of fall weight jacket because it's not like some big winter coat. I mean, I live in Kentucky. I mean, it gets hot here. So you don't need a big, thick, heavy coat this time of year. See what I'm saying? And then the very last kind of fashion related item I'm going to mention, animal print shoes. Okay, listen, I'm all over this trend because they go with everything and they just give your outfit such a little pop, you know? So any kind of animal print, and what you're going to want to do is use this as a neutral, okay? Treat this just like you're wearing a black boot or something like that, honey. Truly. Both of these happen to be from J. Crew simply because I'm a J. Crew addict, okay? Hi, my name is Erica and I'm addicted to J. Crew. Hi, Erica. So these are like some loafers, okay? And this kind of, I don't even know, polka dot animal print. What is that? It ain't a snow leopard, honey. I don't even know. Love those. I wear them all the time. If y'all look at my blog, I do a lot of like what I wear in a week to work. You will see those all the time. And then the newest babies to my collection, honey, these little cheetah ones, cheetah ankle boots. These have like a 2-inch heel. I ain't afraid to wear a heel, honey. Uh-uh. Wear these all day, every day. They are so cute. And like I'm wearing them again this week. My favorite way to wear a cheetah print shoe, black and white striped shirt. So cute, honey. Get you some of them. So let's just say you don't want to spend, you know, whatever J. Crew. Those were on sale, by the way, those cheetah print booties. But say you don't want to spend a whole lot of money. There's this shoe at Target, okay? It's by the brand, again, A New Day. I love these, okay? I like the red, too. They're just a basic little flat. I love the way they're flat across the top of your foot, the little pointy toe. And if you're like me and you wear like a red lip like all the time or little pops of red in your outfit, I can't recommend the red ones enough. Like they're really, really cute. But these do in fact come in the cheetah print. So if you're looking for a really cute shoe that is animal print but affordable, look at A New Day from Target. I love these. What I will say is I had to size down in these. I'm normally at 8.5. I had to get an 8 because they kept falling off my foot. Keep in mind, I have crazy high arches. So, and there's not a lot of, you know, the whole middle of your foot is open. So it might just be the fact that my arches are so high. But I did have to size down in those because they kept falling off my feet. One of my favorite things this month, my coffee mug. I mean, delight in the little things in life, the simple things in life, right? How cute is this? Come on. Have y'all ever heard? Okay, this is dirty from this one. You know, I drink coffee every morning, so here it is. Have y'all ever heard of Ray Dunn? Okay, let me hold the mug up, let you see it. She, you know, has her own line of stuff. You can find it at Marshall's, TJ Maxx, Amazon, eBay, places, Kirkland's, if you have a Kirkland's, okay, places like that is where you're going to find Rae Dunn. Her stuff is adorable. Like, I love this mug. It's good. It's big. It's kind of irregular. If you can see, like, it kind of dips in right here because, like, she's a potter, I guess. I don't even know. But it's, like, kind of, it ain't perfectly circular, things like that. I love this mug. So this is my Halloween mug, okay? What did I get? Well, honey, you know I had to get one for Thanksgiving because it's coming up next. Gobble. And y'all know my nickname from when I was little. My cousin Justin couldn't say Eric, and he called me Erky. And when he wanted to be mean, I was Erky Turkey. So I love that, right? On eBay, people are price gouging. So I don't recommend doing that. I can't stand for people to do that. That's just mean, okay? But keep your eye out. Sometimes you'll find a nice person that sells them reasonable, okay? I did pay $20 for the Hocus Pocus mug, but I figure I pay that for a good mug anyway. But if you find them at like TJ Maxx and Marshall's, you're talking like $4. Yeah. So then one of my friends, he bought me this mug because it looks kind of like, you know, the Rae Dunn mugs. And it says Lexington, because I am in fact a Lexingtonian now, right? And I just thought that was so sweet that he seen it. He said, I seen it and thought of you, and it is totally me. And I love this. How sweet is that? He's also the one that had me this made a couple months ago. So my little notebook with my name on it. And then, guys, what else is left? Okay, I guess it's just some home stuff. Whenever the seasons change, what's one of the first things you do? You hit up Bath and Body Works, right? So we have a bunch of sinks in this house, like a bunch of sinks. So I bought every pumpkin flavored hand soap that they have. Hands down, the best one out of them all, the caramel pumpkin swirl. It just smells the best, baby. Look, it's already almost gone. And then the candles, this is never going to change. Marshmallow Fireside and the Leaves candle. Do you all have, does your local Walmart or Meijer, wherever you live, sell the brand Sensationals? Like the little wax melts that you put in your tart burner? They have a new flavor this year called Honey Crisp Apple. 100% smells like the Leaves candle. Oh my God. The Leaves candle, if you didn't know, it smells like the Hallmark store in the mall. Just that warm, yummy, light, kind of apple-y scent, but in a good way. Because I'm not an apple person. It's just, it's so good. Everybody who smells the Leaves candle, they're like, that's the best candle in the world. And then I love Marshmallow Fireside. Like, it's just, oh, it's crazy good. So, guys, I think that does it. I'm sure there's probably some things that I have forgot to mention, but for the most part, that does it. Wine and Mustard clothing, my girl Emily's palettes, my new highlight, and yeah. Guys, thank you so much for watching. If you have any recommendations for me, please leave them down below. If you have any funny photos that you want to see me and my girl Angie reenact, leave it. Well, you can't leave it down below. Message it to me, okay? Instagram, Snapchat, wherever you want to send it, I will do it. Guys, I love you so much. Thank you for loving me and supporting me when I'm so irregular with uploading and things like that. So I will see you in my next video. Bye.